संसार सिंधुत्तरणे हृदयं यदि सार संकीर्तनमृतरसे रमते मनोश्चे प्रेमां बुधौ विहरणी यदि चित्तवीति चैतन्य चंद चरणे कुरुतानुरागम चैतन्य चंद चरणे कुरुतानुरागम संसार सिंधुत्तरणे हृदयं यदि सार संकीर्तनमृतरसे रमते मनोश्चेत् प्रेमां बुधौ विहरणे यदि चित्तवीति चैतन्य चंद चरणे कुरुतानुरागम चैतन्य चंद चरणे कुरुतानुरागम शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद There is a big gulf between this material world and transcendental world. That big gulf we cannot bridge up. That is not possible for us to bridge up that gapping until and unless we are 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Prabhupada used to say many times, if we can harmonize our heart with Guru Vaishnava, then we can get maximum most benefit. We can be benefited. If we can harmonize our heart with Guru Vaishnava, then I can come out successful in my bhajan. Actually, I wanted to discuss so many things yesterday, but I couldn't discuss in details. Yesterday I told that Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, acting as Acharya, and in Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada, if we see his acharyaship, then we can follow that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings, all we can find in applied form in Prabhupada, we see. So before discussing anything about Paratattva regarding Siddhanta, we say that Krishna na Chaitanyat Krishnat Jagati Paratattva Paramiho. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the extreme point of Paratattva, is the extreme point. Now with this word you can have some finite conception. You can have some finite conception in your heart that Maharaj telling that Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the extreme point of Paratattva. But you must be careful about this word. Though I say it is extreme point, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the extreme point of Paratattva, still you should not think that Paratattva is end here. Though extreme point, still it is extended towards infinity. That extreme point is also to extended up to infinity. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, I think you have gone through this chapter where Krishna himself telling, there's those gopikas, they love me so much, I cannot give any example. They love me so much, I cannot give any example. When they see me, watch me, they are getting extraordinary enjoyment. And when I see them, I become with delightful attitude, I am watching them. But when they say I am very satisfied watching them, then become more and more energy they get. This way, both Gopikas and Krishna competition going on. There it is written, there is no place, this prema is actually infinity prema. But still it is extended, there is no place for extension, but still it is extended up to infinity. There is no place for extension, but still it is extended. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written. Really it is fantastic. Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Goswāmī Prabhupāda Param Vijayata Sri Krishna Sankirtanam is the only slogan of Gauriya Math. Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Goswāmī Prabhupāda Param Vijayata Sri Krishna Sankirtanam is the only slogan of Gauriya Math. If you can understand the meaning of this slogan, then you can identify yourself as Gauriya Vaishnava. Saraswat Gauriya Vaishnava. I already told many times that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ignited the fire of Sankirtan in Siva Sangan, and that fire going on and on for infinity period. It was started by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but still that fire is going on. That Sankirtan fire, Sankirtan Jagyagni, Sankirtan Jagyagni fire going on. Śrīla Saraswati Thakur telling, Prabhupada telling, those who are 100% ready, unconditional surrendered soul. If they are 100% ready to sacrifice their life for the entire satisfaction of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then they are Gauriya devotees. They are Gauriya devotees actually. 100% satisfaction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is only possible by 100% Sankirtan. If there is not 100% Sankirtan, I mean if there is no complete Sankirtan, complete Saranagati, if not there, unconditional and surrendered, and as per our spiritual line, if we can have the chance to hear our Guru Varga, that according to that instruction, we can sing again. It is called Guru Parampara. If you are diverted from that track, we cannot say you are in line. Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Goswāmī Thakura Prabhupāda telling, even slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Padma ultimately can throw you out of bhajan. How is that possible? You know, if there is one point, and if two straight lines meeting that point, making some angle, maybe it is equi-angle, but still angle is there. One point is there, two straight lines meeting here, so one angle. Maybe it is very fine angle, 0.005 degree angle, or maybe more finer than that, but still angle is there. But if these two straight lines, which is meeting in one point, is extended up to infinity, then I can say it for sure, I can grasp the total globe. Because if this point extended, then if I extend this two line up to infinity, then that aperture is enough to grasp the total globe. I can catch the total globe. So you see, if I am deviated from the track of Guru Pad Padma, slightest deviation can ultimately throw me away from bhajan. So within that period, if you try to reconcile your heart with your Guru Pad Padma, it is good. You try to reconcile. Maybe you don't understand the meaning of your Guru Pad Padma. Why Guru Maharaj is acting this way? Why he is acting this way? Why? What is this Siddhanta? If you cannot understand, then you must approach a Suddha Vaishnava. Then he can explain, clarify this point. Still, you must. There should not be any gapping with your Guru Pad Padma. Then you can come out successful. So, Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. Prabhupada telling, not Param Vijayate Krishna Sankirtanam. Not that. Param Vijayate Krishna Sankirtanam. Not that. Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtan. Sri must be there. In Gopi Gita, in Vrindavan, we explain Jayati Te Dikam Janmana Braja Sata Indira Shashadatrahi Daita Dishatam Dikshutavaka Taidita Sabo Twam Chinvate. Nice, in Vrindavan we see Jayati Te Dikam Janmana Braja. At the Advantithi of Radharani, we explain this sloka in Vrindavan. Nice explanation. Those gopikas, they are singing, "Oh Krishna, when you take birth in Vrindavan, when we find that your Abhirbhav, when you discover your Abhirbhav in Vrindavan, we see everywhere as if Mahalakshmi, Radharani is there, as if everywhere we feel her presence, in nature, in water, weather, in hill, trees, all speaking the presence of Radharani. Gopika is telling. At the same time, when you take birth, Jayatite Dikam Janmana Brajo, Jayatite Dikam Janmana Brajo, Sreta Indira Shashad Atrahi, Shashad Atrahi, Atramani here. Simultaneously we find Krishna as if Radharani is there, secret meaning. Everywhere good symptom, everywhere labri, all nature dancing, all nature, whole nature dancing. What's that mean? My Radharani already there. You cannot see. Actually, in the Bhagavat Mahima we discuss, when we discuss Bhagavatam, we speak this. Atmaram Krishna so. Dhruvam Atma Asti Radhika. Atma Ramasya Krishnasya Dhruvam Atma Asti Radhika. It's the glorification of Bhagavatam. Skanda Puran. They are saying, know it for sure definitely that the heart of Krishna is Radharani. Without heart you cannot live. Not possible. So know it for sure, Radharani is the heart of Krishna. Atmaramasya Krishna. So why you speak that way? Krishna is Atmaram. He is satisfied himself. Krishna? Who is Krishna? Krishna is the complete figure. Paratatta, complete figure Krishna. Like one flower, you see? Lotus flower. Just in the night time you see it is closed. Then morning coming, around 4 we see it is starting to get in full bloom, but it's gradually. Then after the sun rises, gradually sun, then after full sun, then it is full bloom. That Krishna avatar is the complete avatar. Krishna avatar is complete avatar, you see. This way we see, there should not be any deficiency with Krishna. There should not be any dissatisfaction in Krishna, because Krishna is Atmaram. Krishna is Atmaram. He is satisfied himself. Regarding Sukhdev Goswami, you also see, Sukhdev Goswami don't want anything from outside. Sukhdev Goswami always satisfied because of bhakti. Bhakti, because of bhakti. Sukhdev Goswami always full of ecstasy, love. Because he is satisfied. Because bhakti is the actual nature. Bhakti is the actual nature. Narad Bhakti Sutra, I can discuss one or two points, but after this explanation. So, Jayati Te Dhikam Janmana Brajo Sayate Indira Shashadatrahi. As soon as we find Krishna, you take birth here. As soon as we find you, Krishna, you have taken birth here on this planet, world. We see that as if Radharani is there. Mahalakshmi. All Lakshmi. We can find different figures of Lakshmi. with Varahadev, Lakshmi, Varaha Lakshmi, with Nishangan, Nishinga Lakshmi, Kurma Lakshmi, Kurmadev, Kurmadev, Tortoise, Kurma Lakshmi. So any avatar, Baman, with Baman also Lakshmi, any avatar of Krishna, I mean, there is one Lakshmi. But all Lakshmi coming from where? Radharani's appearance, we say, we shout and say, Ananta koti Vishnu loko namra padma yarchite himadrija pulo moja viranchija varo prade. In morning time we say, Ananta koti Vishnu loko namra padma yarchite himadrija pulo moja viranchija varo prade. In infinity world, where you go, there you can find Lakshmi Devi is there. But all Lakshmi, where from coming? When I start bandana, then say, as see, bandana, I say, there, padanokhi, from the finger end of Radharani's lotus feet, one light coming, transcendental light emitting. From there, in infinity world, Lakshmi appear everywhere. So Radharani is the only source. Radharani. So we see why Prabhupada telling Param Vrijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam is the only slogan of Gauriya Vaishnava society. Why? Because with Radharani, glorification of Krishna together with Radharani, a pastime, everything is completed there in Mahamantra and Panchatattva. When you say Sri Krishna Chaitanya Pavanitrananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda, then you must be sure that in this Panchatattva all complete Leela of Radha Govinda is there. Complete Leela of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there. You should not express any doubt. You should not have any doubt. It's a very secret Siddhanta. In Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. In this Mahamantra, all pastimes of Krishna you can watch. You can watch if you are elevated up to that level. If you are elevated up to that point, you can watch. Your Harinam can speak. You see, you are doing Harinam. At the same time, you see, this is Vrindavan. This is transcendental Leela going on in Vrindavan. Same thing here. Adyapiyo sei lila kore gaur rai kono kono bhagyavan dekhibare paye. Some lucky personality, they can watch Gauranga Mahaprabhu Srilila still going on here, but everybody cannot see. Everybody cannot see. Everybody cannot see. Like in Gita, you see, when Sanjay wanted to see the things happening there in battlefield, he cannot see. By the mercy of Ashwadeva, he developed that kind of eyes. He is sitting in front of the blind Dhritarashtra. You see, he is now sitting in Hastinapur. He is blind actually. Who? Dhritarashtra. Dhritarashtra want to see. Dhritarashtra want to know everything. Then Vyasamuni, Vyasadeva saying, well, I can bless you, you can see. Dhritarashtra saying, no, I want to get the relay of that battlefield. Only relay. Then we see Vyasamuni give blessings to whom? Sanjay. And Sanjay can see everything what is happening there in battlefield. He is just watching everything and he is giving a direct relay of what is happening there in battlefield, you see. But here, if you want to see what is happening there in transcendental Gaur Dham, what is happening there in transcendental Vrindavan Dham, so you must develop your vision. You must have that kind of darshan. You must do your bhajan. Then you can watch. So Prabhupada telling, Sri Krishna Sankirtanam, Param Vijayate, Param Vijayate. Param Vijayate, not Vijayate, Param Vijayate. Any Vishnu avatar manifesting Leela, any Vishnu avatar, Kurma avatar, Nishinga avatar, Ram avatar, any avatar, they are also manifesting some Leela. We have a chance to go through those Leelas. In Bhagavatam, in Puranas, we have the chance to go through those Leela. But you see, Krishna Leela is most exclusive in nature. Why? Because in Adha Avatar Tattva, though is complete Tattva, all Vishnu Tattva complete. But there is positive, comparative and superlative degree, a comparison. If we go for comparison, if we like to have a comparative statement about Krishna Leela and Ram Leela, we can see that Ram Leela is not complete Leela. Ram Leela is not complete Leela because in Ram Leela we cannot find all complete rasa, we cannot find in Ram Leela. But in Krishna Leela we see all Santo, Dasa, Sakho, Basalya, Madhur, all five kind of rasa you can find, you can exchange with Krishna. It's only possible with Krishna and Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. All of five kind of rasa is only possible, complete, you can exchange. With Krishna you can find. But in Ram avatar, we cannot get complete. And Nishinga avatar, what to speak about Nishinga avatar, we cannot give. There is no such mellow. There is no such mellow. So, Sri Krishna Sankirtan is complete. Sankirtan. When you do Krishna. And I told you that day, in Upanishad we find one sloka. Raso Vaisha. In Upanishad, we find one sloka. Raso Vaisha. Definitely, know it for sure that Krishna is the only source of all rasa. Krishna is the all. In material world, in this material world, material planet, everybody exchanging, getting some rasa. Maybe material rasa. Material rasa and transcendental rasa. Two kind of rasa there. One is pure rasa, transcendental rasa, another is impure rasa. Impure rasa, all jivatma here, they are all getting rasa, because without rasa, nobody can live. Some or other way, everybody getting some rasa. Even birds and insects, snake, wild animal, everybody getting some rasa. Bala Maharaj, can you prove that they are enjoying rasa? Yes, I can prove. If you want to kill them, they are running. Why? They like to save their own life because they are getting some test out of their own life, right? Why they are flying? If you want to give this stick to mosquito also fly. That mosquito like to enjoy your nice blood, suck blood. So it also enjoying? So enjoying differ. It man to man, jivatma, jivatma, they differ. One dog also enjoying something. One pig also enjoying something. I like to take nice stool, very nice stool. A pig eating nice stool is getting energy. Today my day is very good day. I am getting nice stool to eat. is going to get enjoyment. Anyway, some or other way, all jivatma, they are getting enjoyment. Without enjoyment, nobody likes to live. Even King of Heaven, Indra Maharaj, he did some mistake. So ultimately he took the form of pig. He took the form of pig for certain period. Like Dharmaraj, you know? Who is Dharmaraj? Yamaraja, Dharmaraj. He took the form of Vidura. You know? Vidura is Dharmaraj himself. But due to Mandabha Muni, curse him. For exact 100 years, you will have to take birth in a low caste. I curse you. Well, you curse me, it's okay. Then he took this birth, as who? Vidurji. So this way, Indra did some mistake, aparadh. So for that, he took the form of a pig in this material world. Now, when the period is over, he can go back now. Because Vidur Maharaj for 100, Dharmaraj for 100 years, punishment. Eh? So there also some period. So after period is over, those demigods, they are coming to give warning before Indra. Indra, your period is over. Now you can go back to heaven. Heaven? Where is that? That place. It's nice place actually. Heaven is very nice place. Oh, nice place. We are coming here to take you there. Oh, I cannot go there. I can get nice stool there to eat. Oh my God, you are Indra. You like to eat stool? What's rubbish? Come on, go. Then ultimately you are taken to heaven. Then you discover I am Indra, you see. That this way, all jivatma here in this material world, they are like Indra. They are making mistake. They are like to enjoy material enjoyment. They like to get all material enjoyment. They don't like to live enjoyment. Somebody smoking. I say, man, why you are smoking? Stop smoking. Maharaj, without smoking, actually, you see, I cannot live. Really so? Smoking is your life. You cannot live without smoking. After that, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, you can discover without smoking your life is very nice. You can live your life. But still you think so, as if you cannot live. All mistake, maya, illusion. So, actually, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu meeting one Brahman, Raghupati Upadhyay, where? In Allahabad. When Vallabhacharya, you heard the name of Vallabhacharya? Eh? He became a big Acharya of Vallabh Sampradaya. Vallabhacharya, that time he was in Grihastha Ashram. He was staying in a village, that side of Jamuna, river. That's Arail Gram, that village name is Arail village, Arail, name Arail Gram. Gram means village. Then he took information from somebody, that somebody coming there in Allahabad, very ecstatic love, and then he coming here and see, it's like Narayan, exactly, oh my God. Then he invite him to his room, you please Prabhu coming, come here, and I like to give you bhiksha, prasadam I like to give. That day one Brahmin came there, his name is Raghupati Upadhyay. Very nice Brahmin. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knowing everything, what is there in his heart. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when discussion going on, in the middle, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling, well, can you speak, can you read something which is exclusive? I like to hear. I am actually thirsty. Thirsty, you know? Not for water. For Russia. Just now I told, without Russia, nobody likes to live. A big that's it, Rabindranath Tagore. one big poem writer. He writing. Marite na chahi ami ei sundar bhubane. Rabindranath Tagore got Nobel Prize. He meet Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He heard Harikatha from Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He heard from his very low age. At the same time, he meet Rosik Mohan Vidyabhushan, great speaker in spiritual line. He meet him. He used to hear Harikatha at the same time. But still, I don't know why he don't develop full spiritual figure. Half his spiritual advancement, development was half done in his whole life. But still, some kind of realization was then in him. Otherwise, how it is possible? I don't like to die in this beautiful world. Why? You don't know? You don't know you are going to die. Anyhow, you will have to die. So why you are speaking like that? But actually, in Jiva Sarup, inside your Sarup, there is no question of death and birth. There is no question of death and birth inside your Sarup. When you analyze your sarup, we find there is no question of death and birth. It's transcendental in nature. Jivatma transcendental in nature. So why you think about death and birth? Because you are put it into illusion, maya. That's why you think, I'm going to die. Let me enjoy nicely so that no dissatisfaction can touch at the time of my death. But complete satisfaction you can get when you are going to get Shuddha Rasa. Shuddha Bhakti, Shuddha Rasa, transcendental bliss can touch your heart ultimately if you can get Bhakti. So Raghupati Upadhyay came and paying dandavat to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asking, I am very thirsty actually. You speak something I like to hear. Then you see, there Mahaprabhu asking, there are so many dhamma, Ayodhya Dham, here Ayodhya Dham, there Rameshwar Dham, Dwarka Dham. So out of all those dham, which you think the best? Which you think the best? Bara Mathupuri Bara. Among all about Dhamma, which is the best? And he's saying Mathura Puri, Mathura Dham, that is the best of all. Acha? And about what figure you like? Because Krishna can appear in different form. Sometimes Ram, Krishna is avatari, he is the main source. From there, everybody, Ram, Barahani, Singho, even Krishna, Dwarkadis Krishna, Mathuradis Krishna, all coming. So which figure you like? Bala Sam Eva Param Rupam. Sam Rup, Sham Sundar, Yasoda Nandan. I mean the son of Nanda Maharaj, son of Yasoda, mother, I like is the best of all figure. Sam Eva Param Rupam, Bara Mathupuri Bara. And what stage you like to do? I would like to think in your mind, what age? Well, age regarding that is adolescent age. Bayo Koisharakam Dheyam. Bayo Koisharakam Dheyam. We like to think about Krishna is just away with energy, always dancing with gopikas, this, that. This kind of figure we like. Not Mathura this Krishna, not Dwarka this Krishna. We like to see. Why? But Nandanandan Krishna can exhibit complete tattva, you can see. So today is the appearance day of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I was discussing some points about tattva, rasatattva, rupanuga dhara. I was speaking something. Priya sarupe, daito sarupe, prema sarupe, sahajabi rupe, nijan rupe, pabhureka rupe, tatan rupe, savilas rupe. That I was discussing yesterday. Actually, Rupa Goswami path, if you can take the complete kipa of Rupa Goswami path, then your kipa is complete kipa. Why? I give you a nice example, try to hear it. Rupa Goswami path, coming to Nilachal Dham. Nilachal Dham. That time, Rupa Goswami path was given a place there with Haridas Thakur. Because Rupa Sanatan, they think we are all fallen soul, we are in low caste, we are from low caste. If we touch even Jagannath Panda, it is very sinful activity. We should keep ourselves away, safe distance we should maintain, so that transcendental Jagannath is Dham, those Pandas, they are running ever here and there, so we must keep ourselves away from them. We must keep a nice safe distance. We have no right to go inside Jagannath temple because we are fallen soul. We are aparadhi. We are actually fallen soul, taken birth in low caste. So we cannot go inside Jagannath temple. So they never go inside Jagannath temple. They only watch Patit Pavan. They only watch Patit Pavan from outside. So humble attitude they have, you see, that Rupa Goswami path staying with Haridas Thakur. Because Haridas Thakur is also always saying, I am fallen soul. So Rupa Goswami path also saying, when Sanatan went there in Nilachal Dham, he also stayed with Haridas Thakur. They think we are fallen soul. That is the only quality to get the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then one day, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming from sea, from Jagannath Darshan, Mahaprabhu, not sea, Jagannath Darshan coming back. And after that, entering into the Bhajan Kutir of Haridas Thakur. There, you see, Mahaprabhu entering into Bhajan Kutir. Mahaprabhu is so tall, Ajan Lambita Bhujau Kanakabhadatau. So tall figure, you see. Then Mahaprabhu entering here. Bent. Then entering there, then Mahaprabhu find one, a plump, you see plump path, huh? Plump leaf. Talpatha, plump leaf. Yeah. There some sloka Chaitanya Mahaprabhu find. Then after that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very, very happy. Then Mahaprabhu, I don't like to discuss in detail. I have so many things to discuss today. Time is limited. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asking to Raya Ramananda and Swarup Damodar, that here I pray in one nice sloka, I am feeling very nice. Priyo Swayam Sahachari Kurukhetta Milito, that sloka I discussed in Leelachal at the time of Ratha Yatra, 3 years back, I think. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saying, I was dancing and singing in front of Jagannath temple, how Rupa can know my mind? How Rupa can know my mood, my bhava? How Rupa Goswami path? What is the reason? Then Raya Ramananda Swarup Goswami telling, Maharaj, he is knowing your heart. Hey Prabhu, he knowing your heart because he is enjoying full kripa. He is enjoying your full kripa. That's why he can know the exact meaning of the sloka. He can know, he can translate your heart. He can translate your heart because he knows your mind, what is there inside your mind. Oh, really, actually so. When I meet him in Allahabad, I think I find him, he is the fittest person to express some rasa tattva. So I give kripa to him. So you all can also bless so that he can write something about rasa tattva. So Rupa Goswami Pad is the acharya of rasa tattva. Rasa tattva. Rupa Goswami Pad explained everything in different scriptures. You see. So there you find there why priyo sarupe daito sarupe, why this answer is that if you are going to enjoy full kripa Rupa Goswami Pad, then you can enjoy the total kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We discuss this point. Simad rupa padam bujo dhuli swang janma janmani. Simad rupa padam bujo dhuli swang janma janmani. We want to become a lotus feet dust particle unto the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami Pad. That is our ultimate goal. We want to become a dust particle unto the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami Pad. We want to become our dust, one single dust particle. When Brahma praying to Krishna there in Bhagavatam, we find that also, you see, Brahma also expecting to take birth there in Vrindavan as a kripa, small kripa there in Vrindavan field, anywhere in Vrindavan field. Why? When Gopika's going, then I have the chance to get their dust particle if I can take the birth of kripa there inside Vrindavan, wayside of Vrindavan. And we find Uddhavji, you see, eternal servant of Sir Krishna himself. He is expressing nice mood, you see. There, our Uddhavji telling, Asa moho charananenu jusam hamsam Vrindavane kimapi golamalataho sadinam jadustajya sajjanamajya patancha hitva bheju mukunda padabim sutibhim vimigram. Those who want to become Rupanugo in actual sense, those who want to become actual Rupanugo, they should hear this point. Asa moho charana renu jusham aham sam Vrindavane kimapi gulmalatau sudhinam. I want to become a dust particle of Vrindavan. Asa moho charana renu jusham aham sam. I want to get one particle from the lotus feet of Gopikas. Then I am successful. So Uddhavji expressed his desire. He expressed his desire in front of Krishna. I want to take birth inside Vrindavan as a kripa. Asamo charan renu, singular number, not plural number, singular number. Asamo charan renu, singular number. If bahuvachan agar use kiya hota to usme kya hota? If he want to use plural number, then reno vaha is asamaho charano renu, one single dust particle. You see the luck of Brahmaji, you see the luck of Uddhavji. So this way, if you are enjoying the complete kripa of Rupa Goswami Pad, then be sure we are going to enjoy the full kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because just now I told the sloka, Priya Sarupe Daita Sarupe is the dearmost person of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Actually, he is the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is there inside Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's heart that can be translated by Rupa Goswami? It's possible. Rupa Goswami is just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mood. What you can find there in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his mood, all you can find complete in Rupa Goswami. What Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to express, that is the same thing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that the same thing that Rupa Goswami want to propagate, I mean preach. Same thing. That's why it is written nice sloka there. So we want to become what is written there? The Srimad Rupa Padambuja Dhuli Swang Janma Janmi. Today is the appearance day of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So I must discuss some points about it. If I forget to glorify Advaita Goswami, then I would be punished. I will be punished. If I forget to glorify the name of Advaita Goswami, especially today, then I will be punished. So, we are getting this Dharma. We know this Dharma. We are sitting here in Dharma. We are chanting Harinam. We are getting everything by the mercy of whom? Advaita Goswami. Advaita Goswami, by out of causeless mercy, Advaita Goswami expressing his deep sorrow. He is watching the condition of material world. Oh my God, how I can give benefit to them. Extreme benefit. How I can arrange their deliberation. How I can arrange their bonded soul. Then Advaita Goswami thinking over and again, all day and night crying. I must do something for this material world so that they can get maximum, most benefit. They cannot think even in their life what kind of benefit I am going to arrange for them. They are actually fool. So he started crying. He started worshipping Krishna. He find a nice sloka in Gautamiya Tantra. There was a nice sloka, just I was discussing this point, Bengali Harikatha. Tulisi dal matrena jalasya chalukena va vikrinite vikrinite swatmanam bhaktibhya bhaktavasalaha. That Krishna is going to sell himself if I provide Ganga water and tulsi leaf, everything, and chandan, sandal. If I touch and throw onto the lotus feet of Krishna, Krishna become very, very satisfied. Ganga water and tulsi. Then Krishna think, oh, he is giving me tulsi and Ganga onto my lotus feet. How I can pay? I have nothing to pay. So I bet, so I can sell myself to him. I like to sell myself to him because he is going to give tulsi and Ganga water unto my lotus feet. I am completely satisfied. So I like to sell myself in front of that devotee. This sloka when Advaita Goswami find in Gautamiya Tantra, he's saying, it's okay, very nice. Then is the point, come on, I can go and sit at the bank of Ganga and day and night I can cry and call, Krishna, please come here. Krishna, please come here. And deliver all those fallen souls. I can request Krishna. I think Krishna is going to obey me. I think Krishna is most merciful figure. He is going to obey me. I'm sure. So he started worshipping Krishna. And he is crying actually, Krishna, please come, please deliver those fallen soul. Then Krishna, out of his own mercy, you see, Advaita Goswami coming, calling, so Krishna appear here, but in the form of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Same thing, but just the color is changed. Molten gold, golden complexion, and Krishna is a dark color. The only color is changed, and mood is changed. Krishna is the only figure who can enjoy the whole world. Prabhupada telling, don't try to enjoy anything. Cut off from your own life. If you have the slightest mood to enjoy any rasa, maybe secretly inside your mind, nobody can understand. If you have any kind of desire for any rasa here in this, from this material world, if you want to get, then you cannot come out successful in your whole life. Be careful. So Prabhupada telling, Krishna is the only super personality who can enjoy the whole rasa, anywhere, any rasa there. Anywhere, any rasa, Krishna can enjoy. Without Krishna, nobody can enjoy. Krishna can enjoy all rasa. So don't try to get any rasa. If you want to get rasa, then sankirtanamrita rase. I told you, sansar sindhu charane hidayam jadi sat. Sankirtanamrita rase ramate manoste. Premam budhau viharane jadi chitta viti. Chaitanya chanda charane kuruta anuragam. Chaitanya chanda charane kuruta anuragam. I was just explaining the sloka. If you want to get delivered from this material bondage, if you are getting some test in sankirtan, if you are going to get some enjoyment rasa in sankirtan, if you want to swim in the wide ocean, infinity ocean of prema, love pollution, then come on man, do sankirtan. Only way, open, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saying. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth, he came with sankirtan rasa. He came with sankirtan rasa. He wanted to distribute this sankirtan rasa among all. Come on, everybody, come on. Do sankirtan. And through this sankirtan, you will be maximum, most benefit you can get. If you have patience, go on doing sankirtan. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared this day, actually Leela is Nitya, you see. Actually, Leela is Nitya, you see. Leela is Nitya. I mean, eternal Leela, permanent. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving answer to Rupa, Sanatana Goswami Pad in Varanasi, Sanatan. See, Leela is Nitya. How Leela is Nitya? Eternal. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu telling, anywhere you can find is whole universe, infinite universe. You can find any Leela, you can find anywhere in this material, in this infinity universe. In this infinity universe, right now, somewhere in this infinity universe, I don't know where, but just now Krishna take birth. Just now Krishna take birth. Somewhere here, somewhere in, anywhere in this infinity universe, somewhere Ram, Bhagavan Ramchandra taking birth right now. So Leela is Nitya. So now, actually in the evening time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth. Ramchandra took birth in the noon time. And Krishna took birth midnight. Krishna took birth in midnight. Ramchandra took birth in noon time. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth in evening time. Nice, actually. So evening time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth. With Sankirtan, he took birth. Why? You can put question, why Maharaj? Just now, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth, he is not a child. How you say, he is coming with Sankirtan? Actually, Krishnadas Kabidas Goswami explaining there. You see, never before today, people can watch that, oh, everybody, those who are averse to Krishna, those who never speak anything about Krishna, still they are also singing today. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. What excellence is there today? What excellence is today? Why all outside material people, they are also chanting Harinam, they are running to Ganga to take bath, they never go to Ganga, they never go to Ganga to take bath. Why? What thing happens? Actually, Tikaka, those who are giving not there, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, they are saying, actually, we Sankirtan Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming. You cannot know the influence of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming or before coming, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving some influence. Giving some. Why? Before coming, that day I told, when important man, minister coming, then some squadron, some military man, policeman going past, left and right, back. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming, he is deputing Madhavendra Paribhad, Ishwari Paribhad, everybody. Those who are going to add something in his leela, those who have some part to play, they have some part to play in Chaitanya leela, right? That's why they are coming. Everybody coming. Jagannath Mishra, Nilamba Chakrabarti, Sachima, Sarvaja Devi, Sivas Pani, everybody with full troops. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming. Maybe somebody coming early. Before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, somebody coming after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we get Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he is the seventh Goswami. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the seventh Goswami. So he is coming much later. So what wrong in it? He is the eternal person of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Maybe he is coming 300 years or 350 years after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's disappearance. What wrong in it? No wrong in it. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu before coming, Advaita Gosai coming, everybody coming, they are somehow doing kirtan, everything, harikatha, everything going on. But special case, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu just appear, then all sun and moon, all nature dancing, you see? Oh, whole nature dancing. And then everybody running, they are going to Ganga to take bath there. And then I don't know what's the reason behind it. They are all singing, Hare Krishna, why they are singing? They never speak like that. Well, the reason behind that, externally super bumper kipa given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Super bumper kipa given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, they are also speaking Harinam. So, this way Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in childhood form, crying, then those gopikas, they're staying in Mayapur, they're saying, Hare Krishna, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stop crying. Oh, see, this child is excellent child. The child always crying. But when you say, hey, Hare Krishna, Gaur Hari, they stop. Ah, really? It's a good signal. So as and when Gauranga Mahaprabhu crying, they say, hey, Gaurari, then Gauranga Mahaprabhu stop. So this way, Gauranga Mahaprabhu give a chance to those gopikas to speak Harinam, chant Harinam Sankirtan, and for Sankirtan Jagya Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, it's all right. All other secret reasons are also there behind it. How Radharani enjoying? I cannot understand actually. What is the mood of Radharani? Why she is enjoying so much? What kind of rasa, what kind of enjoyment there in me? I cannot feel it. Actually, I cannot feel it. So I must take the mood of Radharani. I can steal the mood of Radharani to enjoy the kind of ecstasy Love is excessive love, enjoy Radharani. I like to enjoy it, but I cannot enjoy until and unless I get the mood of Radharani. So this is the reason behind it. For why Gauranga Avatar is there? Why Gauranga Mahaprabhu coming here? The reason, very secret reason. Parvati, you know? Who is the wife of Shankar Bhagavan? Shakti of Shankar Bhagavan. One day asking Parvati Devi, "De Prabhu, you are always speaking Chaitanya, Jai Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Whose name it is? What is Gaur? You are always dancing, Gaur, why?" Shankar Bhagavan, dancing, you know? Shankar Bhagavan dancing with Gaur now. Who is Gauranga? Then, what is this Gaur Dham? This Navadip. What is Navadip? Then, Shankar Bhagavan, Mahadev, is answering. You see, Devi, Jang Eva Radhika Krishna, Sa Eva Gaur Vigraha. Jang Eva Radhika Krishna, Sa Eva Gaur Vigraha. Jaccha Vrindavanam Devi, Navadipancha Tatsubham. Devi, I say Gaur is the Krishna and Radharani unify themselves. Radha and Krishna, unified form is Gaur. Be careful. Jangeva Radhika Krishna, what you think Radha Krishna in unified form? We say Gauranga. Go mean Govinda, Ra mean Radha, unified form, then Gauranga. Same Krishna is there, but color is covered up with Radharani's complexion, body complexion, you see. So there we find Shankar Bhagavan saying, Jang Eva Radhika Krishna, Sa Eva Gauravika, that is Gaur. What is you think, Radha Krishna? Is Gaur. Jang Eva Radhika Krishna, Sa Eva Gauravika, Ajacha Vrindavan Devi, you think this is Vrindavan? That is same thing. Navadiv is same thing. You don't know. Vrindavan and Navadiv same. Gaurabha Javane Bhedna Manibo Haibo Radharo Dasi. You sing in Kirtan? Gaurabha Javan, Vrindavan and Gaurvan. I should not think if this Tata is complete, one Tata. I should not make it separate. Gaurabha Javane Bhedna Manibo. I should not think it is separate from Vrindavan Dham. Is same, I should think. This way you see, actually Vrindavan Dham and Navadvip Dham are same, and Gauranga Mahaprabhu same with Radha Krishna. That day I was explaining in Bengali speech that day, Yatha Yatha Gaura Padar Binde Binde Tavaktim Kitapunna Rasi Tatha Tatha Utsarpati Hidya Kosmat Radha Padambujo Sudhamburasi. According to the degree of your inclination unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, according to the degree of your devotion, you can get the chance to unveil the covering of Vrindavan Dham. Then you can see what is happening there in Vrindavan, what Radha Govinda doing. Is there one ladies and gents doing all nonsense, you see? Radharani is ladies and Krishna is gents. So, just when I started my speech, I told there is a big gulf between this material world and transcendental world. You cannot bridge up this gapping. You cannot bridge up this gapping until and unless you are enjoying full kripa of Guru Vaishnava Nityananda Prabhu. That gulf is red and red. The color of that gulf, you know? Big. That gulf is red, totally red, whole red. Not gulf green. Green gulf. It's red. Red? What do you mean by red? By the bloody conception of blood and flesh. That is called red and red. Wherever you see, You have the conception of blood and flesh. Oh, blood and flesh. That is why I am saying it is red and red. Bloody conception of red. Blood and flesh. So we must get rid of this material darshan, blood and flesh. Then you can have the chance. You see? This way you can see Dham, you can enjoy staying in Dham, you can do Harinam, everything. And regarding Nam Tattva, just now, oh, 2 hours before I was discussing here, regarding Nam Tattva, Rupa Goswami Pad wrote one nice sloka, which is just exclusive sloka. Rai Mahasaya, Nama Ramananda Rai and Swarup Goswami saying, in our whole life, nowhere we find that kind of glorification of Harinam Tattva. Where from? How? Rupa Goswami Pad, Rupa writing this so nice. We have, no, we have in our knowledge many glorifications of Nam Tattva, many scripture we find. But this is exclusive. It is very exclusive in nature. Tunde tando viniruting vitanite tundavali labdhaye karna kroda karambini karna karnar budibhyo spriham cheto prangana sangini vijayate sarvendhyanam kitim no jane janita kyadbhut amritik krishneti varnadhyayi. This sloka was written by Rupa Goswami Pad. Exclusive sloka. Someday if you are going to get this kippa, you can dance just. If your clothes all gone, if you are naked, then still you cannot feel. Like Madhira Madhandu in Bhagavatam, we see, like one man, he is taking wine. So much wine he take, he cannot understand his clothes is there. It's not. In Madhira Madhandu, in Bhagavatam we find, just like a man is drinking so much wine, he cannot understand the clothes is there in his body or not. Leave me, I'm okay. Don't disturb me. This way. But actually we find, if you get the taste of Harinam, same condition you can find like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all six Goswamis, you see. That's why it is written. Then nija bhajana mudram padisam sabakte bhyo sudyam nija bhajana mudram padisam sachaitanya kingme punarapidishwar yaswati padam chaitanya stakam. We find the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu just coming here to show the secret way of Rupanugadhara, Manjari. But if you jump like jackal, you cannot touch that grape, sweet grapes. Grapes? Then you can say, oh, grapes are sour. I shouldn't get it. But you must follow line. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Bhajan Rasa writing, Bidhi margo rato jane, sadhinata ratna dane, rag marge karai praves. It's an automatic factor. It's an automatic factor. You need not fight with Rupanugadhara, Raganudhara. Automatic factor. If you go on following Guru Varga, if you can organize your life accordingly, then today or tomorrow, you can get the total taste of Harinam. And if you are going to get the taste of Harinam, inside that Harinam, you can find Namer Kolika Prem. Inside Harinam, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. In this Harinam word, you can see Krishna himself dancing. Now you see, some words are there. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, it's a word, man. But Nam Prabhu. Inside that number, when we going, if you go on doing Harinam, someday is Harinam touching you, then you can say, oh my God, you can see everything. Bhaktivinoda Thakur even just me. Someday Harinam going to give you full kippa, You can see all lila, everything inside Harinam. Inside Harinam. All rasa, all kripa, all lila, you can find Harinam. So, Harinam bhajan is the complete bhajan. But for that, if you say, I should not do Guru Seva, you useless. I should not do Guru Seva. I must do Harinam. But that Harinam cannot touch you. There is some procedure. I can discuss this point, you can understand. Have some procedure. Bona fide procedure. Huh? Nice. So you see, Rupa Goswami Pada glorifying the name of Harinam, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, today I appear with Harinam Sankirtan. So I must know something about it. So tunde chandavini rutinga bitonite tundavali labdhai karna kroya karammini ghatayat karnar budhebhya spriham cheto prangana sangini vijayate sarvendriyanam kritim no jani janita kiyadbhut amrit kishnati varnadhi. I don't know what spell is there. I don't know what spell is there with this Harinam Mahamantra. I am just paralyzed. And my body and all sense organ, all paralyzed. I cannot move my body. What condition I develop? Really? No jane. All my organs, sensual organs, are useless. Now I cannot understand what happens with me. Now only I find my mind and all sense organ as if pointed and directed towards one and single matter, that is the Krishna Naam, all the pastimes of Krishna, beauty of Leela, I can see. I don't know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So you see, nice glorification. I cannot catch my tongue. Don't stop! Stop speaking Harinam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu staying in Gambira. When I go outside for, you see, toilet, so, you see, Mahaprabhu choking with us. Actually, that time, I catch my tongue. Because my tongue don't obey my order. Always tangling. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna. So, I catch my tongue. I tied my tongue with a string. Then Gopal Guru Goswami telling, oh my God, actually, there is no time and no instruction there. You can do Harinam any time. For toilet, lying, any time you can do. So why you are going to stop your tongue? Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing. Oh, he is my spiritual master. He is advising me. Here, everybody should speak. He is Gopal Guru. He is actually Guru. Everybody should speak. He is Guru. From today, his name is Gopal Guru. He is advising me nicely. Actually, it is Siddhanta. Niyamita smaranena kala. First sloka? Second sloka, what do you say? Second sloka? Sikha stop? Nama nama kari bahuda. Nija sarvahasti stattarpita. Niyamita smaranena kala. Itadrishitava kibha bhagavan namapi. Duddhaivam idrisham. Mihajuni nanu ragaha. Oh my God, so much facility you are giving to us, but still I am not getting any power. I am losing all chance, any kind of chance coming to it. I am really, my luck is very bad. I am lucky, I am getting chance, but still I cannot develop that kind of... You see, my luck is very ill luck, you see. So I cannot do Harinam. There is no time and restriction. Any time, when you are sleeping, you are sick actually. Go on doing Nam. When you are crossing the river in boat, go on doing Nam. When you are taking prasadam, still you go on doing Nam. Without Nam, you cannot live. Go on doing Nam. Non-stop Harinam. Even when you are sleeping, then you can also you do Nam. I have seen in the life of my Guruji, lifetime. My Guru Maharaj doing sleeping. I see my Guru Maharaj sleeping in night time. But my Guru Maharaj sleeping, I find because I am material person. I am staying there with Guru Maharaj night time. Guru Maharaj sleeping, I find Guru Maharaj's tongue dancing. Guru Maharaj sleeping, but tongue dancing. What happens? Oh my God. Always doing Harinam. Non-stop Harinam, you see. So this way we should get our practice. We must get habituated to do Harinam all the time. Without Harinam, we should not live. So Harinam Kippa, Dhamma Kippa, Nam Kippa, all coming to us all the time. But we are really unlucky, we cannot get it. But in someday, if I get the chance to discuss about 8 slokas given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I can discuss. But be careful, first sloka, Cheta Darpanam Arjanam, I can discuss some point. Not today, I have no time, because I need to go. Chaitanya Gauriyam are there. There you see, first sloka, their condition of bonded soul. Second sloka, I am unlucky. Third sloka, condition of how you can have the chance to sing the glories of Harinam. I mean Harinam, how you can. How you can have the chance, what quality, minimum quality you should attain so that Harinam can dance, Harikatha, Harinam can dance in your mouth. Tinadu visunichana tararu visayishnana amanina manudino kittaniyo sadahari. Fourth sloka, in short I am telling, only I am touching. Fourth sloka, there should not be any slightest desire inside the heart of a jivatma. Who is going to enjoy Harinam in future? If your target is that, you are going to get the full mercy of Kipa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I am in the Kipa of Harinam. Because Harinam is same with Krishna. Harinam is same with Krishna. So then, fifth sloka, fourth sloka, after that last, what he find? What he find? Taragir? Jugaitam nimeseno chakshushapabhishetam. This is a nice sloka. This is the condition when Harinam doing full kippa to you, then you can find jugaitam nimeseno chakshushapabhishetam sunnaitam jagata sarvam gavinda virahenam. Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? I like to die. Without Krishna, I like to die. That is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You must learn it. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming? To teach us what kind of mood you should develop inside. Then you can have the chance to meet Krishna. So you see, we are really lucky. We have the chance to do Harinam, Harikatha, we have connection with Transcendental Guru Vaishnav. Why you are going to get bad association? In Bhagavad Gita, na sat vidyate bhava, na bhava vidyate sata. This sloka, if I discuss some point. So where is asasanga? Why you sing evil association? Everywhere good association. Don't think like that. Everywhere you can find Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj, Srila Keshava Goswami Maharaj, everywhere you should find. Here Keshava Goswami Maharaj standing, Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj. You cannot see? You are blind? Prabhupada standing here. So you can see. You can see everything there. So, bad association, you will have no question of bad association. You can get good association. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Vancha kalpa sarvasya kripa sindhu bhavaja, patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo. Question, actually, those who are Hindi people, Punjabi people, they are disappointed. I must speak something for them also. What question?
Yes, when Mahaprabhu Mahaprabhu gave definition of Kanishtha Achikari. He told that devotees, he should once chant
Krishna,
he should chant pure name of Krishna.
Actually, I am very sorry. Those are all basic factors. Those are all basic factors already discussed by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada. Even in the footnotes of Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can get all answers. Even I repeatedly quoted in different books. But still nobody go through those literature. I mean, actually, if you can utter one pure name, if someday in your whole life, if one Harinam, pure Harinam can touch you, then you are Kanishtha Adhikari. With aparad, if you are going on doing Harinam, I am doing so much Harinam, I am not elevated up to Kanishtha Adhikari stage. Even I am not elevated up to Kanishtha, I think so. I am not elevated. So if pure Harinam someday touching you, then just you can enter into this Adhikar. I mean Kanishtha Adhikar can touch you. And even in Kanishtha Adhikar, there is three stage. Preliminary Kanishtha Adhikar, second Kanishtha Adhikar, and third excellent Kanishtha Adhikar. That I can discuss. Rupa Goswami already told. So never mind. You go on doing Harinam. Only the thing you will have to watch, only you will have to think that there should not be any aparad. Naturally, aparad can come, touch you, it can disturb you, but that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Narottama Thakur advised her, when my mind is just diverted to material thing, my Guruji ordered me to do Harinam, I am doing Harinam, but my mind going to Bombay and Delhi. At that time, some material factor coming into my heart, then Narottama Thakur advising Bhaktivinoda Thakur, oh man, then south, oh Gauranga Mahaprabhu, oh Nityananda, where is Srinivas Acharya, where is, you can shout with the name of Krishna, Vaishnava, don't speak Krishna, now stop Krishna, stop speaking Krishna. Now only shout, oh save me, where is Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Where is Prabhupada? Please save me, I am dying. Please give me a chance. Then automatically all your naughty mind can obey you gradually. As and when your mind is disturbed, that time shout. Just go on shouting, please save me, where is Madhav Goswami Maharaj? Please save me, where is Bhakti Balakrishna Goswami Maharaj? Where you are? Maya killing me, Maya kicking me. Please save me. You see the result. Tokhon dekho, jokhon disturb korbe, kalke bolchilam uttor debo. Sei shomoy chitkar korte hobe, amay bachao, bachao. I am just gone, I am the drowning. A drowning man catches at a straw. It is not gospel. It is not gospel. It is most practical factor. Your life should be like that. You are drowning. So you must catch at a straw. Means you must try to get the help of Guru Vaishnava and try to save yourself. Try to save yourself. Those who help themselves, God help themselves, those who help themselves. God help them, those who are going to help themselves. It's right, right Siddhanta. English people speaking right Siddhanta. The Siddhanta, exact Siddhanta. So, Vanchakalpadarvasi ki basindu vevacha patitanang pavanim Vaishnava bhyo namo.